Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In the last video, we learned the steps of installing and configuring web interface. In this video, we'll learn the steps of publishing application on Citrix XenApp Server. We are on Citrix XenApp Server now. To open Citrix App Center, click on Start, click on Administrative Tools, click on Citrix, select Management Console, and click on Citrix App Center. Click on Yes to allow an executable to run. .NET is asking for the startup changes. We are not changing anything. Click on Ask Me Later. To configure and run the discovery, click on Next. Uncheck Single Sign-On as it's out of scope for this video and click on Next. Add the Citrix server that we want to administer. We'll select this local computer. Click on Add Local Computer. This will add CTX01. Click on Next. Click on Next again. Discovery is in progress. During discovery process, it checks all the Citrix services, primarily IMA Service. It also checks Citrix connectivity with datastore and couple of other things. If it fails, then we'll see an error message in description. Great, no error. This confirms that Citrix XenApp installation and configuration is successfully completed. Click on Finish to close the wizard. Now let's start with the process of application publishing. Expand farm name, that is new farm. Expand servers. It shows list of servers that are part of this farm. To publish application, select application and click on Publish Application. Click on Next. Type the name of application that you want to publish. We'll publish pre-installed application for this demo, that is Notepad. We'll define the name Notepad and the same we'll give in description. As we want application to be accessed from a server, therefore we'll select an option that is accessed from a server. We'll discuss all other options in future videos. Click on Next. We need to specify location of application. Click on Browse and browse the application executable. Notepad is located in C, Windows, System 32 folder. Command line is to define the path of application executable. Working directory is to define the path of application executable file. Click on Next. To configure server on which this published application will run, click on Add. Double click Servers and select the server on which application is installed. Click on Add and then click on OK. We can also add multiple servers if the same application is installed on multiple servers and we want application to be load balanced. To specify users who can access the published applications, click on Add. Open domain name, that is ProHut.net. Type credentials. Please ensure that you have at least read-only access of your Active Directory. Open users and check Show users. It will display all the users. Select the user to whom you want to grant access, and this demo will give access to TU1. Add the user and click on OK. Click on Next. To change the icon, you can click on Change icon. Click Add to the Client Start menu if you want the application to be visible on Client Start menu. Or if you want an application to be visible on client's desktop, then check the option Add to Client's Desktop. Click Next. If you initially want to disable this application, then check the option Disable Application Initially. For advanced options, check Configure Advanced Application Settings Now. We'll talk about advanced settings in future videos. Click on Finish to close the wizard. As we can see, that application is published. Next step is to access an application from client machine. We are on Win 7 machine. Let's open Internet Explorer and browse web interface URL, that is wi01.prohut.net. It says click install to access your applications. If we click on install, it will take us to internet to install Citrix Receiver. Citrix Receiver is required to read ICA file. Let's click on skip to log on. I want to show you an impact of not installing Citrix Receiver. Type user credentials and click on log on. We can see Notepad application. Click on an icon to access the application. We are not able to open an application because we have not installed Citrix Receiver on this machine. Now, the next step is to install Citrix Receiver. We can even install Citrix Receiver from Citrix XenApp Media. Let's map DVD of Citrix XenApp with this machine. Right-click DVD and click on Install or Run Program from your media. Click on Yes. Click on Manually Install Components. Click on Common Components. Select Plugins and Streaming Profiler. Select Citrix Receiver. Citrix Receiver is installed successfully. Click on OK to close the window. Click on I will enter the URL later. Open Internet Explorer again and browse wi01.prohut.net. Click on the top ribbon and select Run Add-on. Click on Run to run ActiveX control. Click on Allow to trust the program. We can see a green check. It confirms that an appropriate client is available on this computer. Type user credentials to whom we have given access. We gave access to TU1 user. We can see Notepad icon. Click on the Notepad icon. Click on Allow to allow an application to run. Great! Notepad is open. We published Notepad on Citrix XenApp server, that is CTX01, and we can access the same from our client machine, that is Win7. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye. Keep smiling and have fun. Mm-hmm.